Okay, guys, he says, I know, this isn't Shell, but you know what? I got good saying anyways. The sad thing is, her banner is coming right after Shell's, like her raid up. So I'm just, it. I kind of wish I didn't get you because I did want to pull on your banner, and now I feel like it's gonna be kind of useless to pull on your banner. Ka-ching, why? It's okay. I'm still gonna be going for Hu Tao, so it's all good. Why are they so mad at each other?
Over there.
The sinister energy is coming off in lots of black-looking flames.
Paimon thinks so too. We've seen plenty of hilly churls before, and they're always the bad guys, but this is different.
Did you forget about Elon Musk? What about the entire Hillitarian thing?
Uh-oh. This is right by the Wangshu Inn too. Oh, the guests are in great danger. Now that we've seen it, if we don't do anything about it, Paimon will feel really guilty. Let's go take care of them.
But they're not bothering anyone, I don't think. Isn't that kind of rude? Oh, they're. Okay, well, now they're bothering me. Nice. I got them. Really? It didn't seem any different to me.
Seems like people are gathering over there. Oh, wonder what they're doing.
Is this like Chong Yun gonna come in? Oh, but bye.
Mention it, this guy's mask is kind of similar to the one that he wears, but the magic he was using seemed even more adeptacy than Xiao's.
Adeptacy.
Shall we go say hi?
Yeah, let's go say hi.
Ahem. Hello. Allow us to introduce ourselves. This is.
Please, if you're here to thank me, there's no need. Cleansing the world of evil is the duty of the Adepti. Think nothing of it. I certainly don't.
I certainly don't. This guy has an ego. He has a very large ego. I can already tell.
Wait, who are you? One had assumed you were followers, but on closer inspection, it seems that we have not met.
My name's Paimon, and this is my sidekick.
I am not the sidekick. Neither of us are the sidekick. I'm the traveler. You're the emergency food.
The one before you is the Adeptus, Master of Stars.
Not the
The one is
stars?
better known to one's followers as Star Snatcher. Fate saw fit that our paths should cross. Now, tell me that which you wish for.
Huh?
Our wishes? Paimon thought that the Adepti and Lilai were just really good in battle. You mean you can grant people's wishes too?
It's pretty advanced stuff.
There are different levels of Adepti. Are not the stars loftier than the mountains, clouds, and moon?
Scientifically speaking, you're right. They are.
Yet, it is
They're still
unbecoming of
doing
an
the
Adepti
cheering
to
thing.
boast of one's powers. One would have you first speak to one's followers, and only then make your verdict.
Okay, let's talk. Male believer, mercantile believer, and female. The three genders, y'all. Male, female, and mercantile.
Watching him use his magic is all the proof you need. A true Adeptus, no doubt about it.
I'm having doubts about it.
Not long ago, I sought some medicine from him on behalf of my ailing father. It was boiled and ready. It gave off this really ethereal mist. Seemed pretty adeptal to me. Could have also been because there was mist flower in it, though. My father will recover soon. I just know it.
His father's gonna die.
Sure, you have to make some sacrifices if you seek help from an Adeptus like the Master of Stars. I had to give a few antiques as offerings.
I'm a merchant,
You look like
and I have an
Boli.
especially valuable batch of goods that needed transporting recently. So I asked the Master of Stars if he would make the journey with me, as presumptuous as that was.
Did he agree?
Reason being, monsters run a mile as soon as he so much as holds up his talisman. We didn't have the slightest bit of trouble the whole journey.
It actually doesn't sound too bad.
It didn't come cheap, of course, but then soliciting the services of a god is a monumental affair.
After my fiance up and left, I cried every day.
Oh, that's not good.
But then I turned to the Master of Stars for help. At his suggestion, I started burning paintings of my fiance and casting the ashes into the ocean at sunrise.
Okay, that's kind of dark.
I can't explain it. But it really worked. I know in my heart that he'll return. This is not some sort of positive thinking trick. I'm certain of it.
It's a positive thinking trick. I am certain of it.
I'm so overjoyed that I gave a portion of my wedding budget to the Master of Stars as an offering.
Okay, they're all broke. Okay, so basically, what I've learned so far is they're all losing money.
What do you think? One's adherents may exaggerate a little, but they speak from the heart. Their wishes are already on the path of transitioning into reality. Does this make things clearer?
It's complicated.
Way more complicated. Mm-hmm. But basically what you're saying is that their wishes can come true, right?
Indeed. You are perceptive, my diminutive friend.
Diminutive.
Okay. So we also have one other question.
Oh? You need but ask.
Yeah. Go on, take it off.
Hey,
let me see.
Isn't that a bit inappropriate?
I don't think so.
Indeed. It would be inappropriate for one to remove one's mask.
What's so inappropriate? Actually, wait. With the COVID situation and all? Okay, yeah, actually that's reasonable.
One wanders among mortals, doing good and cleansing evil. One reveals not one's visage to avoid further disturbance to this realm than is necessary.
I think it's just really ugly.
Now then, what are your wishes?
I like to get rich quick.
That you hail not from Liyue is manifest in your appearance, but one senses their materialistic influence upon you.
There's nothing wrong with that.
So be it. This wish is not beyond one's power to grant, but first, one must see some proof of your faith.
Understand him at all.
Yeah, I think he wants money.
Oh, that's right. Some of those believers mentioned that they had to pay a pretty sum for the Adeptus' help, didn't they?
Wasn't he the one who just said, like, ah ha ha, materialistic ideals, and then now he wants some money?
Well, Paimon's not forking over anymore, and we don't have anything valuable enough on us. Hey, why don't we make him a tasty snack? No one can resist the temptation of good food.
Nom. Can they? Sounds good.
Yep, a tasty snack is sure to work.
Oh, the laugh.
Why don't we head over to Wanwen Bookhouse and see if they got any new recipes in?
Wait, why would there be recipes in a bookshop? That doesn't even make any sense. Wait, what? Okay, I'm lost. Oh, you're here too.
So, you'd like a copy of Yaksha's The Guardian Adepti?
Yes. Here, and keep the change.
Oh, what a generous guy.
Oh, aren't you generous?
Wow.
Thank you for your patronage.
How do you get here faster than us?
Hey, isn't that, Star Snapper? What a coincidence running into him again.
Coincidence or Adeptus?
Yaksha's The Guardian Adepti? Well, anyway, it was definitely a book about the Adepti. Why would an Adeptus want to buy a book about himself?
Like I said earlier, large ego. Yeah, narcissist.
Could be. But now that Paimon thinks about it, there's something that's just not right about this guy.
His mask is so ugly.
That's true. It really is. Very suspicious.
Mm-hmm.
We should check out that book. Maybe we'll find out something about this guy that we can use. We'd like a copy of Yaksha's The Guardian Adepti. Do you have one in stock?
You should be able to find a copy somewhere on that shelf over there.
Okay, gotcha. Shelf over...
Are you buying or not?
Over where? Oh, here. This is not a shelf, you know? It's a table.
In ancient times, Liyue was a land of misery. Where the shadow of evil loomed large.
Hi, Zhongli.
As slain gods festered, their vengeful wrath cursed the world, manifesting in infernal forms. When demons stirred, miasmas, monsters, and mutations infested the land.
Pyra Regisvine.
Then Rex Lapis summoned the Yaksha's to vanquish the demons. They swore an oath. Restore order through slaughter.
You look like Ganyu.
To this, we dedicate our lives. Eons of bloodshed later, karmic debt weighed upon them. Phantom wrath seeping into their broken souls. They went mad with fear, turned on each other, or succumbed to the darkness. Of the five foremost Yakshas, death came to three, while the fourth vanished without a trace.
The Electro One.
In the millennia since, one conqueror of demons remains the sole surviving Yaksha in the mortal realm. And only on moonlit nights, in the glow from Guyun, and in the sound of the Dihua flute, is his memory preserved.
Yo.
This book is about the Yakshas, a group of adepti who defend Lyra. There used to be five main Yakshas, but supposedly only one of them is still alive today. Do you think that it could have anything to do with that Star Snatcher guy?
Nah.
No, surely not. He doesn't exactly give off the impression that he's been suffering for thousands of years.
That's a really funny way to put it.
Hey, wait a second. Paimon wonders if... Do you think those super evil hilly trolls we saw earlier were the mutations that the book's talking about?
Ooh, I even nodded.
Isn't by the hateful thoughts of the gods, the Yakshas would often descend into indescribable fits of terror, rage, or agony.
Wow.
Oh, it's so tragic. After everything they went through and all of their years of protecting Lyra, they got no reward and had to deal with so much suffering instead. Paimon thinks we've already summed up all the key points.
Well, you did. I do appreciate you doing that, though.
So back to the matter at hand. The things we need answers on are 1, where did those super evil-looking hilly trolls come from? And 2, what does Star Snatcher have to do with the Yakshas, right?
Yep.
Now to head back to where this all started and commence our investigation. Let's part the fog of mystery that hangs over Dwayne Karst and let the truth shine through in its full glory.
Yay, we're gonna play detective.
To Wangshu Inn.
Okay. Oh, well, the hilly trolls are back. I can tell you that much. It's gonna work this time around?
Flee at my command, foul demon. Flee! Why won't you flee?
Yeah, go flee. I don't know my Hilatorian. I'm sorry, I can't translate that.
Uh-oh. Looks like Star Snatcher's in trouble. And there are innocent bystanders here, too. We have to step in.
Do we, though? Like, do we really have to? I'm using Ganyu, because then technically they're being beaten by an Adeptus, and I just think that's really, really funny. There we go. Yeah, beaten by an Adeptus. See? Thank you, Ganyu.
Oh, I don't get it. Why didn't the Sigil of Permission do anything?
Sigil of Permission? Oh, I remember those.
Has the evil aura of these hilly churls grown in intensity?
Oh, the face. Oh, the faces.
Sigil of Permission, huh? Now, why does that sound familiar?
The Get Out of Julian Free card.
Right! It's a keepsake of the Adepti. So it must still contain traces of their power. No wonder he was able to scare those monsters away earlier.
What are you two babbling on about? One is merely underslept, meaning that one's adeptal power is not in full flow.
I don't think so, my good sir.
Were one but given another opportunity...
Well, as it happens, there goes another bunch of evil hilly trolls over there. Should we leave them to you, then?
Oh, Paimon.
One suddenly feels ill at ease. Surely one has overexpended one's adeptal powers. Otherwise, one would surely purge these infernal beings at once.
So you were just bragging after all. We were right to be suspicious.
Yeah, your mask is just that ugly.
Come on, Traveler. Looks like it's up to us. Use your elemental sight and hunt them down. Oh, it's that conqueror of demons again. No wonder. Paimo was just wondering who could have made such short work of these hilly churls.
Ayo, Shao.
Let's see what a real adeptus has to say about...
How you doing, Shao?
It's you. I remember you.
And I remember you.
I was purging some living beings that had been tainted by the demonic. It would appear that I have caused you some trouble. It's because the changes that occurred in these monsters stem from me. Or more precisely, from the karma I have accumulated.
Dark backstory time.
Mutations? Karma? Oh, does that mean...
So Xiao is the final Yaksha? Yeah, I know he is. It's great.
Yeah. Paimon remembers that Xiao is also called the Vigilant Yaksha, isn't he?
Is he vigilant? Is he a Yaksha? I think so.
So that means... Oh.
Oh, Paimon.
Poor Xiao.
We're just reading a book called Yakshas, the Guardian Adepti.
I see. You must mean that piece of literati fan fiction from a few hundred years ago.
Fan fiction? Oh, that's hilarious.
All things are impermanent, and to exist is to suffer. We Yakshas have no need of sympathy or tears.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It matters not. In any case, I am on my way to purge a cavern of demonic influence, so we shall part ways here.
Just imagine just leaving, just like talking to someone, and all of a sudden you gotta go, and you're just like, I am on my way to purge a cavern of demonic influence, so we shall part ways here. That's such an epic line.
Wait! Take us with you! We'll be a big help! Paimon promises!
Yeah, we will.
No need. I'm used to fighting alone.
DPS Chow.
In any case, these mutations originated from me to begin with. Finish your preparations, and we shall enter. We should not leave those monsters be for too long.
Oh, this place gives Paimon goosebumps.
It looks so cool, though.
I will use the ritual known as the Bane of All Evil to relieve this place of its karma. You must remain calm. Do not allow yourself to be affected by the lingering wrath of bygone gods.
Yeah, Paimon.
Evil conquering!
Just do this. Oh my god, that's so much fun.
Tear! Worthless! Worthless!
Worthless!
Tear!
That Star Snatcher guy wears his mask the rest of the time too.
That's because Star Snatcher.
I am aware of no adeptus by such.
Oh right, he has high jump. I was like, wait, how am I supposed to get over there? I swear to god, I'm gonna fall off one of these platforms. Boing.
Worthless.
Boing. Boing.
It's good that we came here. An unusual number of living things had fallen under infernal influence. Had we not arrived in good time, the consequences would have been unthinkable.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this Star Snatcher you speak of, what is the situation?
He's a fraud and his mask is ugly.
Ooh, Paimon will tell you. That fake adeptus has a sigil of permission. It's what he uses to exorcise demons.
Wait, truly? Fool. Exorcising demons without exterminating them. It is no wonder they have been congregating here.
Mm.
If this continues, things may spiral out of even my control. We must confiscate his sigil of permission.
Can we get rid of him too? Just only confiscate?
Great minds think alike! Paimon agrees. We've got to show that trickster what you get for trying to fool us.
Mm-hmm.
And it just so happens that we've got a real adeptus with us too. If Xiao were to teach Star Snatcher a lesson, you can bet he'll never dare to pose as an adeptus ever again.
No. I only slay demons. I do not kill mortals.
laughs in killing the Fatui skirmishers and also killing all the treasure hoarders. Ah, ha, ha, ha.
Who said anything about killing him?
I take a point. None of us said anything about that.
It would certainly benefit Liyue if we could convince him to cease his wicked ways. I possess an art called Dream Trawler. It is normally used to separate the soul from the body, that one might cultivate oneself in a waking dream.
Ooh.
But it can also be used to call forth the spirits of others.
Ooh.
Whoa. Now that's a real adepti art for ya.
You'll scare the wits out of... Yeah, yeah, you probably will.
A ritual must be performed for this art to be used. Assist me in gathering a few items. Two Yaksha statues that stand guard beside a merchant road on the southern face of Mount Tianhong.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
The ancestors of the people of Liyue built shrines there to honor the Yakshas. You should still be able to find some ceremonial items there. Once you have found them, meet me at the Yaksha statues after nightfall, and I will teach you how to use this art.
This seems to be an area. Hello, good sir.
The spirit soars the mountains high, while the body rests as the world goes by.
Oh, there's another poet.
Sorry to interrupt you, but...
Well, I'll be. Isn't that something?
Yeah, I know. Paimon is like emergency food, but I guess you could also call her something.
A pair walk into a shrine, neither to seek nor worship gods or adepti, but to pilfer the tools of worship for their own ends.
Okay, well, in our defense, it's for an adepti, so, yeah.
We know it's rude to ask, but we just need them for a short while. Honest.
For the Dream Trawler ritual, I trust?
I'm assuming Xiao has notified him.
How'd you know that?
I have been in the shrine for far longer than you would expect.
Aren't you kind of bored?
Perhaps as a reward for my faithfulness, I have been endowed with some understanding of the Adepti arts.
Star Snatcher has got to learn some of this stuff.
Take what you need. It is a fortuitous thing that these items may be of service to you.
And seven.
Paimon thinks we've got all the ones we can use now. But let's say bye to that guy before we leave, shall we?
Where's that guy anyways? Is he gone?
Huh? Where'd he go? He was right here!
Oh my god, he got turned into the bird statue.
I presume that once you had acquired what you came for, you would forget about me and simply be on your way.
Wait, so he did become the statue. What?
It's that guy's voice! Hello? Where are you?
My physical form ceased to exist over 1,000 years ago. What you witnessed earlier was an illusion, created by the Adepti art known as Mortal Lingering. Now that you have taken the 7-star lamps and censer used in the Mortal Lingering ritual, my form is no longer visible to you.
It's not a ghost. But it's the funnier answer, so.
It is not untrue to say this. The line between Adepti and ghosts is a fine one indeed.
Ooh.
I was once a junior in the Order of the Yakshas, bestowed with the name Pervases by Rex Lapis himself. Yet my strength failed, and I was slain in battle.
Oh. That's really sad.
Today is the anniversary of my death. My last wish was to see a modern Liyue, and so I took the liberty of performing this ritual here. That aside, you were sent here by the Conqueror of Demons, were you not?
Mm-hmm.
So, you two know each other then?
I sense his aura upon you. That and the heavy burden of his karma.
Okay, that's dark.
Even after all these millennia, he still must endure such tremendous suffering. I am truly ashamed.
There, there, feel better.
Don't say that, Pervases. You sacrificed your life for Liyue, didn't you?
Eh.
Life is a precious thing, yes. But when I think of the burden that the Conqueror of Demons must bear, death seems to me to have been the easy way out. A selfish indulgence, even.
Hervases.
I apologize. Birthdays are joyful occasions. But by the same token, it is hard not to be melancholy on the anniversary of one's death.
I want to say, yep, can relate, but honestly, I really can't.
Mortal lingering will not last much longer. Take care, you two. And please pass on my regards to the conqueror of demons. If only I could taste some authentic grilled ticker fish once more.
Oh, the way he said ticker fish.
By
oh, that was nice.
By storm, I hunt for fish. By wind and snow, I slay evil.
Why is this so sad? There. Look, it's Beto's ship. Ha. Huh. Hello there, Shao. How are you doing, my good sir?
Have you gathered the items for the ritual? This sensor and these lamps. Their designs are flawless. Almost as if they were made specifically for use in the Adepti arts. Where did you come by them?
Oh, and, he says hi!
Yeah, he says hi.
Pervases. Yes. This does have the hallmarks of something Pervases might do. Let us begin preparing for the ritual. Place the sensor in the middle, and surround it with the 7-star lamps. Adorn the area with the items of abject cold.
Abject cold.
Once this is done, we shall proceed.
Okay.
Yes, this will do. Now, the next step is the key to performing Dream Trawler. There are 4 steps to performing this ritual. Offering incense, meditation, incantation, and loosing an arrow.
Like a real rigmarole.
Adepti arts are the product of millennia of study by Adepti. Do not dismiss their mystical workings as rigmarole. Failure to take this seriously could cause the technique to devour one's own body, or cause the spirit to be sundered from one's flesh permanently.
That actually sounds really interesting.
Stop talking! Paimon, sorry!
When offering the incense, we place the incense into the censer with reverence for Rex Lapis in our hearts.
Yes, Mr. Zhongli.
Meditation is to empty ourselves of trivial thoughts, and to focus on the target of the art we are performing.
Oh, well this definitely isn't gonna work, because Paimon's always gonna be thinking about food.
Then we shall recite the incantation in a loud voice. Devayaksha, bring forth Sin!
Devayaksha. Huh.
Finally, we will loose an arrow towards each of the Yaksha statues to enlist their authority for our contract. If all goes well, Star Snatcher's soul will be brought forth shortly.
Understood.
If you have no other questions, let us begin.
Bring forth Sin!
Paimon, you messed it up. Incorrect, you didn't say Devayaksha. Now our soul is gonna be torn from our flesh. That really is too bad.
Close enough. Leave the rest to me. You two get ready to greet him.
Ayo, what?
There's one. You two look familiar. What's with one's body? One feels light, weightless.
Guess what? You're already dead.
Dead. Impossible. One was just lying in peaceful repose at Wang Shu Inn. Wait, that must be it. Of course it must. As expected of an adeptus such as oneself.
Whose self?
One must indeed be in a dream.
There's no helping this guy, is there?
Dreamers, after all, feel no pain.
What is the meaning of this? Do you truly think that one will permit such insolence in one's own dreams?
I hope so.
All right, time to take him down a peg.
Okay. Wait, he's like a treasure hoarder. Oh, that's hilarious.
Such impertinence. Where? Hey, hey, stop it. Stop it. Ow! What's
Thank
happening?
You, Ganyu.
Is this really not a dream?
He is a treasure hoarder. He did the whole...
Please stop. I surrender. I surrender.
Oh, he said I. Oh my god, he said I. That's crazy.
No. No, never again. You almost killed me. Oh, how did I ever have the misfortune to meet you two?
Hey, you just said it was a good thing.
You deceived the masses with quackery. Masquerade as an adeptus. Exorcise demons without exterminating them. And display a callous lack of regard for life.
Ooh. Ouch.
One day, you will reap that which you have sown. For those who invite the infernal into their lives, there is no redemption.
There is no redemption. And your mask is ugly, dude. Boom.
Seems like Shell's got him scared stiff.
Oh, great Adeptus. Might I ask your name?
He's a vigilant yak. Actually, Conqueror of Demons probably sounds slightly more threatening in this scenario.
It really is you. It's truly you. Never in my life did I imagine that I might meet the Conqueror of Demons, the vigilant Yaksha himself.
He went from confident fake Adeptus to scared treasure hoarder and now to confident follower of the Yaksha. Okay.
You know about Xiao?
Of course. My grandfather was a folklorist. I learned the tales of the Conqueror of Demons at his knee.
Oh, does that explain why his mask is kind of similar to Xiao's?
To this day, I am an avid collector of books concerning the Yakshas.
Oh, that explains that from earlier.
Ever since I discovered a sigil of permission while rummaging through my grandfather's personal effects, at first, I was just imitating the Adepti for fun. But slowly, I began to stray further and further from the righteous path.
Huh. So to sum you up, you're Xiao's biggest fan?
Yes. Thank you both for allowing me to witness the Conqueror of Demons in the flesh. It's like a dream come true.
Star Snatcher is a fanboy.
That wasn't quite our intention.
Yeah.
Oh, great Conqueror of Demons. Please allow me to swear this oath before you.
I love how he says that, but he isn't even looking at Xiao. It's very funny.
I swear to turn away from evil, to live an honest life, and to never again stain the name of the Adepti.
Okay.
I will remember your oath. Now go.
Thank you. 1,000 thanks for your forgiveness, and for all that you have done.
He said go. Why are you still here? Oh, he really did just go.
He was really earnest when he was making that oath there. Guess he won't be tricking anyone anymore. Oh, wait. We haven't gotten the sigil of permission back yet. Let's head over to Wangshu Inn first thing tomorrow and look for him. Hey there, boss. Star Snatcher's staying here, right?
The kitty cat.
Star Snatcher. You mean the false Adeptus who wore a mask?
I can't tell if she's saying that as, oh, she recently figured that out or she already knew it, but it's Virgil Debt, so I'm pretty sure that she already knew it.
He signed in here under the name Wang Ping An.
Ooh.
He's already checked out. He said he wished to go on a solo pilgrimage. Ah, yes. He also requested that I give this letter to a traveler who journeys together with a talking fairy.
Talking fairy. For him. This is a floating child. Talking fairy and emergency food.
Well, anyway, you must be the traveler. Here's the letter.
Long gone era, yada yada yada, false Adeptus, I am one who always wears a mask, only needs it when facing demons, hide the evil, okay, yada yada yada, yada yada. Wang Ping An, a sinner. That's a very great way to sign things, okay?
Along with... Woohoo! The sigil of permission!
What are we even gonna do with that?
Paimon hasn't met a bad guy like him in a long time.
Thank you, Xiao.
Yeah. Anyway, let's go take the sigil of permission to Xiao, shall we?
Xiao, shall we? Xiao, shall we? Why are you over here, dude? Are you gonna have the grilled ticker fish?
Ah, there you are. We got the sigil of permission back. Do you want to take it?
You have my thanks.
Hi, Xiao.
May I take your order, sir?
Yeah.
One grilled ticker fish.
Certainly. We'll prepare it for you immediately.
Huh. No almond tofu this time? Well, that's not like you.
Mm.
Ticker fish was Pervasi's favorite dish. I just wanted to see how it tastes.
When he says it like that, it makes it sound like all these years, all these thousands of years, he's never had grilled ticker fish. And I just think that's hilarious.
Huh.
By wave and storm, I hunt for fish. By wind and snow, I slay evil.
Wow, that sounds familiar.
Was there anything else? I am accustomed to eating alone.
Yeah, we'll leave you.
Uh-huh. And so, Detective Paimon and the trusty traveler solved the case and quietly slipped away.
Ooh.